Welcome to Life Devotions. I'm Robert Mosbach. You know, King David was a man who faced the challenges of life in his own family, in his role as a king, as a politician, just as a man in his own soul, in his moral soundness, in his significance, value. He had challenges, and yet he was anointed of God. And yet he had God's word burning in his heart. And yet he was a man who knew how to worship, how to make music with instruments, how to sing. He was called the sweet psalmist of Israel. He was called the flame of Israel, the light of Israel. The man had such a good reputation in so many ways, and yet he had these challenges. But I want you to know that one of his great secrets of success is the same secret God has for you today. And that's what God wants us to discover. The things that he's prepared for our welfare, the things that he's prepared for our joy and our success. And they're not hidden necessarily because they're secret. No, they're secret because people aren't discovering them. But I want you to discover today something that was the secret of David's success. And that was that God himself was his mighty protector. God himself. You see, sometimes we think, Lord, what prayer should I pray? We think, Lord, what scripture should I read? Lord, what song should I sing? What service should I attend? What should I read or listen to or do? We think about the secret coming out of some of our own actions. And it's true. When we act in faith, it opens our lives to God's miracles. That is true. But the real secret of success in David's life was God himself. It's no different than what God said to Abraham when Abraham was grieved that he had no children because his wife was barren. God says, I am your reward. I am your shield. When Moses said, Lord, but who shall I send? Say, send me. God said to Moses, say, I am, send you. God himself is the answer. And David, he said in Psalm 71, he said, in you, O Lord, I put my trust. Let me never be put to shame. He says, deliver me in your righteousness. I will hope continually. I will praise you yet more and more. My mouth shall tell of your righteousness and your salvation all the day, for I do not know their limits. I will go in the strength of the Lord God, and I will make mention of your righteousness and yours only. And you see, what was the secret of David's life was that he knew that God himself was his mighty defender, his mighty provider, his mighty helper. And he had a personal relationship with God, and that he believed that he was the same yesterday, today, and forever, and that he had not changed. And even though David may have made his mistakes, he knew that God's love hadn't changed towards him. He knew God's faithfulness towards him was the same every day. He knew that God's faithfulness was there for him every night, in his love and kindness every morning. And he says, morning, noon, and night, I will seek you, Lord. He knew that if he had the Lord on his side, he could face anything. When he had to go as a young man against that great giant, Goliath, who was over 9 feet or 11 feet tall. I mean, he was very tall. And he looked very strong, and he had been a warrior from his youth. When he had to go up against him, he knew that the secret of his success was that the Lord was with him, just like he was with him when he came up against a bear or a lion. And friends, whatever challenge you face today may be bigger or smaller, but the answer is the same. The Lord himself is your strength, and he is your salvation, and he is with you right now. He said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I will not betray your expectation of me. I will show myself strong. But I understand we get tested sometimes beyond what we're able to bear. But in that we will discover, when it's more than we can bear, that the Lord has been carrying it all along, that he's been our strength. You know, I want to pray with you today and believe that that grace, that strength, that power of God's presence comes all over you to encourage you so that you could come through into wonders and miracles God's got prepared for you. Let's pray together, shall we? Heavenly Father, thank you that you're so faithful to us, that you're always with us, that you never leave us nor forsake us, and that you show us the way through into great miracles and answers you've prepared for us. And I thank you for your blessing, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen, and God bless you.